myself, I'ma get it by myself, yeah. I'ma get it either way, I don't even gotta say what I want, when I want, they just put it on my plate. I could get it right away, take you through my day to day, work and pray, make that play, get some good at my place, there's some on the way, cause my bro's on the way. I got stones on my gold, I got loads in my safe, had a 7-figure summer, so I'm putting on some weight, set up. Getting thick, so I put it on display.
You're scared, man.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
I'ma get it either way. What I want, what I want. Jordan stuck on.
No hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'm a boy. One foot is set. Boy, till there's nothing left. I know.
The man said he had the grill and stuff today, bro.
All right, coach. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there.
He on the road?
At Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Philadelphia Eagles. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Aggressive play call to start this game. It backfired, but aggressive, no question about that.
Is that one of those statement calls? Trying to let you know that they're going to be aggressive right out of the gate, but that one hung up just a little bit too long. He made a nice play on the ball defensively and was able to pick it off.
They run on first down as they get about three. Second and seven, forthcoming. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Throwing is Stafford. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Lady! Check 56. Guys, game situation. Let's go.
Stafford on third down.
Standing there to make a play and you just don't, man. That truck annoys me.
17 yards and a first down for
Philly. I click on here triangle and nothing happens.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. Out of the gun, Stafford. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is fielded a couple yards deep.
What up, Chan?
Where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And to be frank, they're just in a tough spot. It's only November, already eliminated from playoff contention. I know their fan base doesn't want to hear that, but and the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down.
Oh, yeah, he's going to pass the 35
before he's So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Let's go.
Right back to him on first down. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite an excellent display of footwork. A gain of 3, second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points.
What's the cheesiest piece of you in ever had?
When they're that high power, you've got to find a way.
Boy,
20 points scored. Give yourself your best chance.
Oh, what I'm going to be eating on?
24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down. So in Saints territory now. Here's first and 10. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He's like, I hope you need to be deep in so I can get
second down.
Inside, man.
Hey, lady! Come on. Check 43. Check.
Gonna give this time to the tailback.
Jay, you're so sorry.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you
got
the treasure
mad
defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Stafford.
Remember in our black.
And nothing but daylight ahead.
I was going to wear dark. This whole thing is
this one home. It's a touchdown. And this defense looking like they have come to play. The pick six, and just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visit. What do we hear during these drills? Oh, pass. Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my
They hold you because you got them big lane niggas, man.
That means if I find someone to block, block them legally, stay on your feet, and they get it done.
Touchdown. Oh, yeah, that fifth year option on dude.
That'll be taken in the end zone.
Who is it on? I'm in white, bro.
Okay. Here's the call.
Here we go.
Officials so cognizant of that call
it,
nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's easier. You see it, you call it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
So I guess
I got a linebacker like
that.
I'm
going it again right away after throwing the pick six.
I'm that nigga go if he wants big money. I just realized he was getting maybe 13 million this year. That nigga ain't worth 13 million.
Go ahead and sling it, big guy.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's got some space here. Now he will be marked down.
Whoa, what difference does it matter?
A big play there for Philly. 56 yards. The Eagles into the red zone for the first time. They've got it first and goal. And oh, he coughed it up. And this is picked up by the Saints. And a big turnover there as these guys will get the football back.
Pardon me, you know how often we hear about the red zone, right? From the 20-yard line going in. That scoring zone, getting points on the board. A lot of teams call from the 10-yard line in the green zone. That's your money zone. He fumbles the ball inside the money zone. You have one job, take care of the ball. That didn't happen.
Forced out to his left. He's going to take off with it. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On second down now, Samuel. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Oh, yeah, he's way past the fucking line. He's going sideways. Way past the fucking bag.
He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the
backfield.
You got
to block the dude in front of you, bro.
What was the point? Who you playing, Flat?
Oh! What was that?
I'm not sure he got there.
That was a touchdown, bro.
They did. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pay.
Jay Real, what the frick was that?
Here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And he'll get this one down to about the 17. 1 yard officially on the pickup. And it'll leave him with a third and 11.
So fucking
a chance of wasting this great starting field position. A real threat. This is third and long. Back to throw. Stafford. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Trying to get that one to his tight end. And they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
Okay.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just three.
Well, getting the three turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach when he ordered the field goal. Please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
That linebacker over came out right there. Play to play, okay.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over.
Oh my God.
Good job by their defense, so they held them through. But this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down,
he's got it at the 15. It's a big play there for the Saints. 61 yards. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's Jackson to throw. Flush to his right. He'll take touchdown there. Saints.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strikeability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And this, let's face it, an important drive they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 46. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
Come on, man.
I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it.
Man, I ain't trade for that yet.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy and can he step into a throw. And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
He's going to take a shot right, and he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Dang.
A big play there. Touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Extra point right down the middle. And the route is on here in this first half.
Big hit on big dog.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Now Stafford. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
Oh, fourth come down, on. Why are you sniffing the other way? That nigga right there.
Here's Beckham. An 8-yard return there after a punt of 47. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
Nowhere to
escape, and he goes down.
That nigga spent 10 yards.
Boy. You got him spinning,
because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget.
That nigga spent.
Huh? Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack.
I'm going to wait till you see it. I'm going to wait till you see it. God damn it, his man coming down with it.
He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent
pace. He's got
2 hands on. Throw right there to move the sticks.
Now a play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. He'll run it. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
What 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
I'm trying to get the fuck away from Big 9-1 that didn't get blocked.
Remind you, coming up at the half, we'll
join
you
talking about?
Charles, the coach.
Right the coach, Jonathan right Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
Sorry,
we get slap happy up here sometimes. To throw
you see that big
one coming up the middle? Jackson, eluding the pressure right. And that is caught. What a catch inside the 5. A big time play there for New Orleans. 45 yards.
I played him.
Are you kidding me?
A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal.
Was that a linebacker on him?
Yes, it was a linebacker. What the fuck is he doing that far back?
Shit, if he wasn't that far back.
What the fuck was my safety?
As his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
That safety?
That, of course, all set up by the big run.
Boy, that
was
a hell of a throw.
They took advantage right away with a touchdown throw.
And you mentioned advantage. Probably taking advantage of their natural instinct after that previous play to be aggressive and rush towards the line of scrimmage. And instead, they were vulnerable to the pass.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Oh, my God.
Stay on your feet and go.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face.
That was going to be a hell of a theme right there.
That was going to be a commission right
there. That was going to be a good
one. On second and a couple. Stafford, and this one incomplete.
Little nigga.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Kelsey, the intended receiver there, and it's third and short.
Hey, watch the ball.
A shotgun snap for Stafford. And he comes back with one complete. The Eagles going to take
out of bounds, bro.
He didn't catch it, though.
The other nigga got it.
Man, it's my fault.
Oh.
Now a first down throw, Stafford.
Oh, this nigga ran out of bounds.
Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. To throw again. Stafford looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And to the 46, he goes and no further. So he is well short of the first down marker. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
Come on now. Come on now. Come on now.
Ah! Woo! I had to come back and get that one.
Like the time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he'll work
don't get him
full,
bro.
Inside the 45. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a round. As
well, Matt, that turned into instead of Hail Mary, nigga tried to do a run play. Well, last second touchdown. Report.
Coach, who that?
That's what man has turned into. Call a timeout to get one more run in instead of trying to hear Mary.
And this will not
be he's trying to
get
MVP and
the
shit, man.
The end zone for a touchback.
They're running back.
Nah, heck no.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
Well,
and I never wanted to make something.
He just got hurt. If he
bull
where?
Is, right? I don't
who
want
that?
To create more hype than what is there.
Bull running back. Who running back is that?
Jay Rhea, bro.
We talk about team scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to
back
get them
strain.
Into the
yeah,
right. Back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
Mm-hmm.
Set, waiting! Mike's 56!
From the gun on third down, Stafford. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down. Stafford now 8 of 17 so far, under 50%. Stafford now to throw. Fighting a safety valve here. That's complete. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make it a second down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play, 2nd and 3. Now Stafford, that's complete to the Memphis man, Anthony Miller. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 35. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game.
Jay just got this shit. This is really cool.
Taken in out of the backfield. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd down.
He even ran the ball.
Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the
interceptions. He got pick artists twice.
Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown.
Yeah, DJ Chark got toast.
And a good one.
Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4.
You better be afraid of me.
Play action. Oh, he almost intercepted it.
Man, we rolling for him so they can talk about he cheating.
That was almost a 4th pick of the game. And now 4th down.
Yeah, that's what you do.
Nah, I mean, that's, to be honest,
and that will knock this down to
that's different from what we was doing.
Point deficit. I'm kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit 3rd quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you.
I mean, that's just like a nigga having 2 post things.
Does it feel a little bit maybe?
How is it different? How is it different?
You gotta go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
Okay, but you got a million different receiver abilities that you can get, but you got post twice. Neither one.
Let's go now.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time out, another touchdown. I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport. That's the roads will be fairly clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Oh, okay.
Play action. It's Jackson. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
And now offensively, it's third and 10.
Get that.
And I'm just thinking to myself,
man, that nigga field is wide open.
What's my motivation?
Oh, you had two things.
Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before this worked well that I can get to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty
gonna be like Chip Drew.
Scoring points, haven't done anything so far here in the second half. They'll rifle this one deep right side, and that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pin upon his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Ooh, that was a touchdown.
Three straight incompletions. They don't care. It hasn't dissuaded them.
I didn't know what level he was for.
Oh. Here's Jackson. And all this is
yeah, it don't matter to me. Yeah, that's cool.
A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down.
It's got to the point where we see guys like that make that type of a catch. Not fair goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right. Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
They'll keep it on the ground. Samuel, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays, and they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones and really illuminate them. Not cool.
To throw is Jackson. Well, he's going to go for it all. And this is going to be intercepted. Hooked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there.
Oh,
his guys
You got two hands.
Put me in an animation, bro. Right,
not a really confident throw either.
Turn around and pick this shit.
Damn.
It's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side, because you've got to find something, some spark.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
Now the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Losing 4 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play.
Oh!
You're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback.
I got into the trap for the
piece. Doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
Oh!
This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? Oh. They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It don't matter.
It feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly. Because
or you can go in and edit them and make them a star or something, then change them back to a superstar.
Touchdown, Saints! A big play there! With touchdown number 3 here in this game, and 17 now on the year as his guys continue to pour it on. Extra point splits the uprights, and that will extend this big lead.
Nah, change him to normal or star, and then back to X Factor.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Already at the line. This
come on, bro. How you let that nigga block you?
They really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means
come on, bro.
What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. On second down, rolling. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped.
Damn, that nigga lost.
It's a loss of 4.
The run stops, man. Down. He supposed to be good shit.
The Eagles on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is third and 14. From the gun, here's Stafford. And it's complete to Kelsey. A big pickup there for the Eagles' first down, 18 yards. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And, wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down is paramount. They could get it done. But guess what?
What the heck are you doing?
Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Call it a 3-yard game.
Oh, stick on me. My fault. I'm thinking I'm running past. My fault.
To the air again, Stafford. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
No, you're not getting cold, bro.
And some space here.
Oh, I didn't know y'all was going to do that.
As they finally get him at about the 10-yard line.
Yeah, that may be all right.
Kelsey was the intended target. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in the game before, and right now after that one, he's standing on number 4.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offense coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? Because my guys have to keep running back out on the field. So play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more. But a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. A good pickup there, 7 yards, and it's going to be second and goal now.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get 4 downs on first down. They did that, plus 3.
That backs him up 1 yard.
You motherfucker! You didn't even block him! Why wouldn't you block him? God, why you wouldn't block him, bruh?
Jackson from the shotgun. Flushed out right. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Odell Beckham.
Oh, that's us, ain't it?
Double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. Man. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for 6. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will swell by 1 more.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that? Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Damn, fucking control the game.
On second down now, rolling. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Call it no gain there. They've got a ways to go now on third down. Facing the prospect of a punt.
Oh, that's a big.
They need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Now a give, right side. Rolling. Fighting to get back to the goal line. I don't think he got there. He did not. Did not get back there. It's a safety. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here. And that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row. They were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through.
Oh!
Now, in certain situations, they will take them out. But for the
man, you take it. Man, you cleared that shit. Man, you house it!
Now he'll let it go.
I should have ran it. Man, you house that shit.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now. Because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone.
Okay, we're going to turn it into a bomb.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Here's Stafford. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Get away, D!
This nigga wide open in there. That's the way I'm talking about.
Oh my god.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
This nigga wide open in there.
That's what I'm talking about, Kyler.
This one's going toward the sideline. They'll try to put a keep away from Beckham. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot.
He dropped it. Oh!
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three
timeouts. That's supposed to be a big heat, yeah.
Use them at this point. Flush to his right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead. But I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
My controller done and shit. Well, you better not get held out there.
Oh, Jackson's going to throw it.
It's not the playoff kick.
Deep right side. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching, and he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line.
Get the fuck out of here.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here. Yeah,
use it hey, man, y'all play without talking.
Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today.
With me and Chain. Yeah, you and Chain.
And never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you
oh, he got down!
Why do they keep feeding him the football?
That nigga controller died. Damn, bro. I had your ass.
He was going to get the first down.
Nah, shit, nah. He was going to get the first down, bro.
Press start, D-Frank. Dang, controller dying, bro. Hold on.
Yeah. Man, you can't plug the motherfucker up, bro.
Man, there's something wrong with it, bro.
Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different
at the end of the game, bro. Come on, man.
So for the Saints,
you should see how I gotta hold it, man. Shit, man.
Now to start
I had to go buy me one.
And they'll have another rematch next week with the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, add another loss to the pile as they drop